Now, Al-Shabaab says the mall attack is a retaliation for Kenya's military intervention in Somalia. Kenyan forces entered Somalia 2 years ago to fight Al-Shabaab militants who had repeatedly crossed the border to stage attacks. For more insight, we're joined on the phone by Nairobi-based analyst Barak Maluka. Mr. Maluka, welcome to Africa 54.
Thank you very much, Vincent.
Yes, now we know that the Al-Shabaab group has attacked Kenya in the past, kind of on smaller scale attacks. Now, is this a game changer? Does this kind of now open a new page in this war?
Yes, definitely we consider that the operation has been a lot more vicious than anything that we have seen before. That they chose a very vulnerable point where there would be not just Kenyan citizens, but as we have seen, the citizens of other nations, that they have also chosen a fairly affluent community. And that even the weaponry that they seem to have brought on board is a lot more complex. But one wants also to acknowledge that we are not just talking about Al-Shabaab. When we talk about Al-Shabaab, we are talking about an Al-Qaeda franchise. And so we should essentially recognize this approach for what it is and the operatives for whom they are. That we are talking about international terrorism and that we are talking about a chapter of Al-Qaeda. It's probably something that we are likely to see more and more, not just in Kenya, but generally speaking throughout the free world.
Okay. Now, Al-Shabaab said, well, we will let off if you get out of Kenya or out of Somalia. They're telling the Kenyans to get out of Somalia. Do you, in your assessment, think this is going to affect how these ordinary citizens feel about Kenya's involvement in Somalia?
I do not think so. If anything, we have seen a lot of solidarity with the government, and it's also true that Kenya was not the aggressor in this particular instance. So it will be recalled that in 2010, 2011, that Al-Shabaab was in the habit of making forays into Kenya, attacking police stations, civilian installations, hospitals, and such other facilities. And it was really in response to this that the Mwai Kibaki-led government at that time decided that it was going to repel such and to push them all the way into Somalia up to whatever point. So it's not like...
Very quickly, what's your assessment of the Kenyan's counter-terrorism capacity in about 20 seconds?
It is basically an emerging one because one has not learned to be all the time fighting counter-terrorism. But counter-terrorism is going to be an international and multilateral effort rather than something that is left to individual nation states to deal with.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Maluka. We do appreciate very much your insight. Barak Maluka is a Nairobi-based analyst. We want to know what you think about Africa 54 and the stories we cover. Join the conversation on Facebook. The address is Africa 54 and check out our headlines 24/7 on voaafrica.com.